How's it going, peeps? It's your boy Ozzy here. Today we were breaking down the Blake Griffin trade and how it affected the Detroit Pistons. And we're coming fresh off a win against the Cavaliers after losing 8 straight. We didn't really have anybody a whole lot playing against this game. Drummond was really the only starter consistently that was playing. We ran Ish. I think we played Bullock, Stanley Johnson, and Tolliver. Now, I don't know what Stan's going to do when Blake gets here. There is supposed to be a press conference today at 4, so I want to see how that goes. But obviously, they're going to be powering it up with Drummond down low. And the way Stanley Johnson played last night, it is going to be a plus if he can keep that up. He's going to be like the third option right now. Take some pressure off of Dre and Blake. If he can stay that consistent, we won't have to trade him. But he is only 21. So we're going to see how that develops. I'm curious to see if we bring him back off the bench or not. But when Reggie Jackson comes back, he's going to go back to being the fourth option. I really want him to see start Luke Kennard. I like Luke Kennard. I think it would be a good way to shut everyone up about taking him over Mitchell. And if him and Stanley can play better, Devin Booker's going to be better than Stanley Johnson. But you can shut that stuff up, too. That being said, the only bad thing I don't like about this trade, and I know a lot of you guys are mad about Tobias. We'll get that in a second. It's a lot of money we're putting in the bigs. I think after so long, Blake Griffin's going to get like $35 million a year. And I think Dre's around the $25 million mark. They were both max contracts. Reggie's got a lot of money. So that's our big three. And that's not terrible. But it's not the Clippers. And I'm tired of people hearing comparing us to the Clippers. We're not going to play like the Clippers. This is not going to be Lob City 2.0. Sure, there's probably going to be a lot of lobs. That's going to happen when you have people like Drummond and Blake Griffin on the same team. But we are built differently than the Clippers. The Clippers were made for high flashy passes and dunks. And then they had J.J. Redick to shoot threes. We really don't have that high volume shooter like a J.J. Redick or anything like that. So I'm curious to see how that's going to play with not having a shooter. But that high post up with Dre, it's gonna get some lobs in there to Blake. Blake's actually a really good passer himself, so they're gonna see some big man assist. It's not gonna be quite like Anthony Davis and DeMarcus Cousins. Both those guys can shoot threes. Blake Griffin can shoot threes. He's not great at it. He's not terrible at it either. So we're gonna see how that goes. I'm really looking. That's the big matchup for me. It's just the salary cap is what's really the main problem. Now, for the guys who are mad at Tobias Harris, real quick, want to say thank you to Tobias Harris for everything he did for the Pistons organization. I like the guy. He was a good player. Not saying anything bad about him. But the problem with this, and again, thank you, Tobias. Don't get mad if you're watching this video for some reason. He was going to leave. Both him and Bradley. They both were going to want max contracts. And unfortunately, Bradley wasn't playing for it or playing well enough to get it. Missing wide open dunks and layups. And we weren't going to pay him. And I really don't think Tobias Harris is worth that much. Don't get me wrong. I like Tobias. But the guy didn't really do anything on defense. I mean, he gets a steal every once in a while, maybe a block shot here and there. But I mean, it was rough. You're gonna look at Blake Griffin now, and I'm not saying Blake Griffin's a lockdown defender, but he's a true power forward, and he can guard power forwards. So you're not gonna see people with this body up Tobias Harris. You're gonna get Stanley Johnson playing small forwards, which they're not just going to body Stanley Johnson because he's strong. They might get past him because they're faster and all that. But now you got Blake Griffin and Andre Drummond down low ready to throw their shit. It's going to be fun. I don't know how people can't like this trade. Basically, we traded, in a nutshell, we traded Boban. I mean, but we didn't play him, so I mean, well, he wasn't getting any minutes. So basically, the way I see it, we basically just traded a first-round pick for Blake Griffin and the other guys we got, which I don't know how much they're going to play. To be honest, I don't really know a whole lot about those guys. I don't know if they're good or not. The one guy was only averaging like 1.5 points his career, so he probably didn't play a lot. And the other guy was just the backup center, I think. But having DeAndre Jordan and Blake Griffin on that same team, he probably didn't play a whole lot. It's a good move. I think it was a desperation move by Stan, especially after losing 8 in a row and getting knocked out to the 9 seed. But they're going to make a run at this thing. You look how hard they played last night against the Cavs. I know the Cavs suck right now. Their defense is terrible. But even though they're still slipping and they suck, they're still a title contender. Rather you think they're going to win it or not, it doesn't matter. They're still in that conversation. So the way we played is great. So far, everything I've heard from Blake Griffin is great. He's changed his number to 23. It looks really dope. I just ordered the jersey. The jersey? Yikes. And it's going to be fun. I'm excited to watch this. I know another knock on it is he's injury prone. And I just hope he stays healthy, you know? I mean, you can't really control if you get hurt. I don't think the Pistons are done making moves. The rumor right now is we're trying to get Rodney Hood from Utah, and that would inquire a Stanley Johnson trade. But I don't know how well that's going to happen. We really need a point guard. We need a good point guard. We need someone who can take over the game when Reggie comes back and come off the bench. I like Ishmith, but he just can't shoot, and people don't respect him. He's not a great defender either. He passes the ball, and he does circles around people, but I mean that's not, it's only gonna get you so far. And he's not like he's averaging 10 assists or anything like that. So I mean, I hate to see him go, but it might be what's necessary for this team. I expect when the Pistons announce if Blake Griffin's gonna play Thursday or not, that's gonna be packed. I guarantee it. They just released his jerseys at Little Caesars Arena yesterday, and I think they sold every one of them. So it's a good time to be a Pistons fan, I think. 97.1, the ticket, for those who don't know, is the Detroit radio station. They talk about sports, everything Detroit. I don't think anyone in there is happy about it, but I want to know what you guys think about this trade. Are you for it, against it? Like I said, I don't personally think we gave up too much, especially since Bradley and Tobias is going to walk. We didn't play Boban. We were just paying him. He maybe got like 2 minutes a game on average. And the first-round draft pick, if we're trying to make a playoff push, it's not going to really matter because we wouldn't have a good pick. And we got a second-round pick in return. So, I mean, I'm curious to see how that goes. Usually second-round picks are more NBA-ready. Not going to be a game-changer probably, but well, you never know. This trade could get Stan Van Gundy fired, though, if it just doesn't work, unfortunately. The only problem with this trade, if it doesn't work, no one's going to want Blake Griffin's contract, since it is so big. That's what she said. But all that in a nutshell, going to head back to work. Hopefully this all works out for the long run, and I'll see you guys in another one.